gentlemen, the Great Desert Race is about to begin. Unfortunately, one of the possible winners, Kim of Flat Hill Country, is unable to compete due to his car being lost in quicksand. But Speed Racer has joined the lineup and in his Mach 5 is one of the top contenders.
Good luck, Speed. Win the race for me.
You can count on me. I'll try to do my best, Kim.
Thank you.
Prince Omar is arriving.
I've never seen the prince. I've only spoken to him through the wall in the fortress, and now finally I'll see him.
My aides tell me that you're the young lady I spoke to through the fortress wall when we were imprisoned together. Now at last I can see your face, and you're lovely. Lovely.
Oh!
There goes Speed, pulling into the lead. I'm sure you'll be the winner. Come on!
Come on,
Speed! Go!
Speed will easily win the Great Desert Race, but what new exciting adventure lies just ahead?
Louis Largent here with you for 120 minutes on MTV. The best in alternative music video, or at least we think so. Every Sunday night at midnight, 11 Central. And tonight you're in for a treat. You're going to see the sweet pop song stylings of the Posies. And they're also going to have a little chat with them. And we got videos from Smashing Pumpkins, Unrest, Primus, Bjork, and Paul Westerberg. Plus brand new ones from The, Bad Religion, Reverend Horton Heat, and 1 hour from now, a world premiere from Midnight Oil. Right now we got a brand new video from the Red Hot Chili Peppers. No, there is no Chili Peppers album. This song is off the soundtrack to the new Coneheads movie. And no, there's no Chili Peppers guitarist either. They're still searching for Arik Marshall's replacement. So all you aspiring Chili Peppers guitar players who've sent your demo tapes in, don't worry, they haven't announced a replacement yet. And the guy who is playing on this song is John Frusciante, the guy who Arik Marshall replaced. And the reason is because the song was recorded back in 1991 during the Blood Sugar Sex Magic sessions. So check it out, Red Hot Chili Peppers with Soul to Scream.
Set it all itself. From my behalf, it's a bit of a joke. And, I mean, you know, the magic of jokes is and humor is, it gives you view. I mean, every time you say a joke, you're kind of stepping one step back and looking on things with a bit of a view, and I think that's a very good thing, you know. If you're too involved, you know, you can't see the funny side of things. And, you know, I just find a bit of a turn on, sort of exciting to kind of step one step back and look at all them humans doing them, you know, interesting things and how they behave, and a bit of a David Attenborough show, you know.
From her album debut, that is Sugar Cubes X, well, that's Bjork with Human Behavior. I've been reading that when she was here that time, she was so adamant about saying the Sugar Cubes were not broken up, but I've been reading over, and that was like 2 months ago, I've been reading since then, she's been having so much fun that the future of the Sugar Cubes is now in doubt. So it's MTV's 120 Minutes, I'm Louis Largent, and Bjork's album shot up to number 27 on this week's alternative radio chart. Hopefully you'll be in the top 10 soon. We're going to give you the top 10 right now as Ireland's Cranberries finally cracked the top 10 with their debut album. Everybody else is doing it, so why can't we? Another pretty well-known band from that same country, U2, have the week's highest debut at 9 with Zuropa. Drama-rama climb a stage to 8 with Hi-Fi Sci-Fi. Tonight's special guest, the Posies, hang at 7 for a second week. Next week's special guest, Urge Overkill, climb 4 slots to 6 with Saturation. Last week's special guest, X, we got all the big stars on this show. They stay at 5 with Jesus. New Order dropping down 2 to 4 with Republic. Tears for Fears go up 1 to 3 with Elemental. And after 5 big weeks in the top spot, Porno for Pyros fall to number 2, replaced by Paul Westerberg and his debut solo album, 14 Songs. Congrats to Paul, and hopefully he will grace us with his presence sometime soon for an interview and a performance here on 120. Everybody else is doing it, Paul. You got to come on and do it. And he did stop by a few months ago before 14 Songs hit the stores and talked about leaving the only band he had ever been in, The Replacements, and going solo.
I guess I didn't even think that far. We never got to the point of, this is the new phase of your career, Paul. How are you going to handle it? It's kind of like I stopped touring and I started writing songs, and before I knew it, I was recording them, and my name was on the sheet that said, you know, this is the recording time. It's like no thought was put into it.
Having a bad summer? Consider the alternatives. MTV's Alternative Nation presents the Spin Doctors Tour.
So sad. What time is it?
With special guests Soul Asylum and Screaming Trees coming to a city near you. Watch Alternative Nation for details. This MTV tour is presented by Apple Computer. The power to be your best.
Back me up around the corner. This is a box of delicious new crack-ups. This is a conehead. Let's compare. Crack-ups are this summer's hottest new snack. Coneheads are this summer's hottest new movie. Crack-ups taste crazy. Coneheads are crazy. Crack-ups are baked. Coneheads are whacked. Crack-ups come in fun flavors. Coneheads are fun. And now they could both win you a trip to France on Air France in the Crack-Up the Conehead sweepstakes. So let delicious new Crack-Ups and the Coneheads crack you up. Catch the movie and enter the Crack-Up the Conehead sweepstakes.
20th Century Fox presents...
Ow! I challenge you to a duel.
The first action hero.
I accept.
And the last word in comedy.
White men can't jump.
Robin Hood. Men in tights.
And why should the people listen to you?
Unlike some other Robin Hoods, I can speak with an English accent.
A Mel Brooks film. The legend had it coming. Rated PG-13. Starts Wednesday, July 28th at theaters everywhere.
With all the preparation that goes into a wedding, sometimes you can overlook the small details even after the big day. What about the wedding dress? Don't just hang it in the closet. Get it cleaned and preserved to last a lifetime. Geneva Cleaners offers complete wedding dress preservation. Whether it's something old or something new, Geneva Cleaners will clean, press, and package your gown and accessories. Geneva Cleaners, 130 West State Street, downtown Geneva, two blocks west of the Fox River. We also do shirts and suits and
Alpine presents completely digital car audio. Mobiltel brings you the sonic excellence of Alpine car audio systems. High fidelity audio performance with unsurpassed reliability. Hear the difference quality makes. Alpine speakers, amplifiers, car stereos. All Alpine systems professionally installed. Mobiltel and Alpine, car audio at its best.
It's 120 minutes. My name is Louis Largent. That's John and that's Ken. They are in the band that you
just
saw.
Who are those dweebs we were just watching?
You know, it's really funny is when people come by here and then we roll in their videos, everybody always looks and, oh my God, we are, you know. Is that painful for you?
Oh yeah, absolutely. It's like a ancient history lesson that we're having here.
It was only 3 years ago. It feels like yesterday.
It feels like a lifetime ago to us. So,
I heard Ringo Starr covered that song. Is
that
true?
Have you ever heard the version? You have never heard the version?
Is it on record, or did he just play it live?
No, it's on record. He doesn't play it live. That's the bummer thing. We tried to get him to do that. But
I don't know why he wouldn't come up and do it with us. I mean, you know, we opened for him once.
How did that happen? And what was your reaction when you first heard about it?
We had no
idea. Even though
he's
only Ringo, I mean, he was a Beatle.
Only Ringo, I mean, let's qualify this now. I mean, yeah, sure, he's only Ringo, but you're right, he is one of the Beatles, and that was good enough for us. I mean, it was such a fluke, we didn't even believe it until we actually heard the actual version of the song. So we were sitting in somebody's management office, and they popped the tape on, and it was Twilight Zone for about 15 minutes. So,
what did you think of it?
It was totally Ringo. What else can you say about it?
He made it his own. I made it my own, he says.
That's right.
Now, this is kind of like a theory that I have. A lot of pop bands, I guess, or lack thereof, it seems like there's the pop genre is there's not an abundance of it. Either you're like rock or it's like R&B or something. There's not a lot of like classic pop bands. They don't seem to listen to contemporary music. Like there's certain artists that like can't get out of the 60s and release just, you know what I mean? Do you guys listen to newer music?
Oh.
Never.
No.
Never?
No.
God,
I mean, never. I mean, you know, it's just...
Kill them all.
Anything past 69 is just...
Taboo?
Taboo. Mm-hmm.
But you know what's funny is all of our 60s influences are actually recycled 60s influences from listening to 80s records that were influenced by the 60s, like XTC and that kind of stuff.
Right. The Jam,
so
Elvis Costello.
We went about it totally backwards.
Because the artists I was thinking about, and not to compare you to them, were like Lenny Kravitz and like Carl Wallinger, who like, the similar genre. Okay.
Mm.
So we're gonna come back and talk to you in a little bit. Right now, we're gonna play a video, a brand new video from legendary LA punk band. I think I used that phrase with X last weekend, but Bad Religion, who true punk rockers, and they are so, this album is so successful. Ken was saying
it's
that
successful that I've heard of it.
He's heard of it. A guy who can't get out of the 60s, he's actually heard of it. They play to like three nights sold out at the Hollywood Palladium in LA, and the reason is probably because there's very few punk bands too, as well as pop bands, and they just do a great job at just being a great punk band. American Jesus is the brand new one from Bad Religion, featuring, I don't know if he's in the video, I actually haven't seen the video yet, Pearl Jam's Eddie Vedder is on the song. Here's Bad Religion.
Expressions on the faces of the stunning millions of power of the man. The few that drives the clan, he's the motive and the conscience of the murderer. He's a preacher on TV, the false sincerity, the fun that had been driven by the big computers and nuclear bombs. The kids with no bombs and a pitfall that he's inside me. Yeah! We've got the American Jesus, see him on the interstate. We've got the American Jesus, exercising his authority. We've got the American Jesus, bolstering national faith. We've got the American Jesus, overwhelming millions every day.
It's a band out of Washington, D.C. called Unrest, and a new video called Isabel here on 120 Minutes. Did you guys just see that fly that was flying by around here?
Yeah, does he have a little mic on him?
John and Ken from the Posies are here. We were talking just a little bit ago, and I was going to ask you a question, and I said you were going to hate it, and you said you could predict what it was going to be.
Well, no, you just...
No. Come on. What do you think?
What do you think, John? I forgot. So you have to
there's, two, there's two things it could be that are our least favorite questions.
Your least favorite question would probably be your the city you hail from.
You avoided the two dreaded questions.
You guys aren't actually from that town.
We're from
in
a town
Washington.
Called Bellingham, actually, originally, which is the question you were going to ask.
Right.
See, that's what I thought, but I had a little bird told me, so... Yeah, I mean, it's like 90 miles north of Seattle, and we kind of grew up there in high school, but...
But you went to... did you go to college?
I went for a measly, like, quarter and a half before I failed.
I was educated in Seattle.
So do you guys...
I dropped out.
Now, when you are in Seattle, and you go into clubs, do people point you go, there's those pop guys, those, like, non-grungy guys over there. Are you outcast in the city of Seattle?
They usually don't take time to point us out anymore. They just start beating us up as soon as we walk in.
Yep.
I'm Kim Thayil.
Exactly.
That's totally untrue.
What are the other two questions that you hate?
Where did you get the name The Posies?
I was not going to ask that.
Good.
And what was the other one?
Something, well, actually, this one's that nobody really asks anymore. It's about the album title, Dear 23, which we set ourselves up for.
You know what, you know what I'm going to ask you for, though? I'm going to ask you about Frosty and the Beater and to describe all
that. That's our favorite question.
That's your favorite? Well, great. Stick around for their favorite question, plus an acoustic performance as 120 Minutes continues.
This summer, be prepared to welcome the newest family on the block. Beldar.
Correct.
Primat. And Connie.
I've always been tall.
Coneheads, rated PG. Starts Friday, July 23rd.
It began for me when I saw Tony Dorsett in the Super Bowl. It began for me when I got the ring. For me, it's still the beginning.
The Reebok preseason shoe at Foot Locker, where it all begins.
Yeah, you're right, Judd. There's no beach traffic.
Easy. I went out. There's a Coke machine.
Man, I'm so hot.
You certainly are.
Hot as in sweaty.
Hey, so crank on the AC.
Air conditioning is for the weak, like yourself.
I'm sticking to the seat like yourself.
That dog is moving faster than we are.
All you guys ever do is complain.
Your shoes are pretty.
Could someone please fan me?
No.
Coca-Cola, anyone?
Yay! Hey.
Thank you, Alan, for serving a purpose in my life for the first time.
Well, you're very welcome. Time together.
Something different, sir?
Please.
Maxell releases a higher performance tape. Maxell, take your music to the max.
Shorts. A loose interpretation of the original.
Just sitting here in my Integra. Yeah, well, I guess technically it's our Integra since I don't make the payments, but hey, I don't get to drive it. Oh, look at this guy. Look, he just spotted it. He is in awe of this car. I love it when humans drool. Oh, he's coming over to check it out. Okay, watch this. I'll give him a thrill. Hey, man, don't drool on my Integra. Woof, woof.
What is a seven-letter word for a tomb in ancient Egypt, which is a quadrilateral masonry mass having smooth, steeply sloping sides meeting at an apex?
A flindar.
Well-bred and well-fed.
Coneheads, rated PG. Starts Friday, July 23rd.
120 minutes.
And welcome back to 120 Minutes on MTV. I'm Louis Largent. Ken and John from the Posies are here. Let's talk about your new album, shall we? Frosting on the Beater.
Shall we?
Got a different producer than Dear 23.
Mm-hmm. Worked with Don Fleming.
Who was in the band Gumball.
Gumball fame. He was in Dinosaur Jr. for that long, too.
For
what, a brief spin. He played on the Wagon.
Mm-hmm. Oh, he did?
Yeah.
And how did you work with him? It's a big change from your previous producer, John Leckie, I would think, it seems like, in styles.
Yeah, I mean, Mr. Leckie is a tech head kind of guy, and Don is just your slacker guy in a band who can appreciate other slackers like him.
That's why we like him.
So.
And well, speaking of John Leckie, for those of you who don't know, he produced the Stone Roses EP that came out in 1988, and they have yet to release another album. And just for my own curiosity, do you still talk to John, and do you know anything that's going on with the Stone Roses?
We get postcards every once in a while, and
he's like always on vacation.
Yeah, vacation, you know, in Greece, still working on the Stone Roses record. I don't know if it's ever going to come out.
Just taking a little break, you know, going to Turkey.
Yeah, you recorded your first album with in your basement.
Yeah, my father and I had a studio together. We put it together in our rec room, kind of, and that's where we did it.
Are you spending like tons of money now that you got a big record label and
on our home studios? Yeah. Our home.
Have you got more technologically
advanced?
Advanced,
perhaps.
Yeah,
but it costs a whole heck of a lot more.
The one thing that is true though is you can never have enough guitars. So no matter how, but it's, you can buy guitars for $100. Like if you can find any guitar for $100, it's worth buying. So you have all these bad guitars in your house.
We have two members of your other band who we want to bring up and give props.
This is
to
our other band,
other,
the Posies.
The other members of the Posies.
So this is the other Posies.
Now here's one of the original members. Mm-hmm. This is Mike, who plays drums, all and right. We have a new member over here.
Dave, the new guy.
Dave, the new guy. Now I heard his first gig was in front of 10,000 people.
It was was it not at the End Fest?
Well, it was like his first. Moment. His first three shows were like.
I'm so embarrassed.
And 10,000 and
15,000.
One of them was opening for Ringo Starr, too. Yes.
Whoa. You guys opened for Ringo Starr along
we
with
did.
Him?
We did.
I did not know that.
And he had Burton Cummings and Joe Walsh in his band. I mean,
but he wouldn't get on stage.
He wouldn't do Golden Blunders with us, though.
Mm-hmm. Why not? He just
he was
can't
tired.
Do that, man.
Tired.
Those guys were out of there 2 minutes after the show. Bam, in the vans, back on the plane.
Drinking Avion and living
exactly.
The best. This is like out in the middle of nowhere, in the middle of Washington, the same place they had Lollapalooza.
Yes, I was. Yeah. For Lollapalooza.
So, you know, it's, you know, we thought, like, well, where is Ringo Starr going to stay in George, Washington? And, like, well, where are you guys staying tonight? He's like, oh, we're staying in L.A.
Yeah.
They, like, fly home after every show. All right, man. Cool. All right.
We're going to look at Dream All Day right now, mm-hmm. from your latest LP. I heard you had gone back and recorded some songs after you had an originally finished album. Is that true?
Well, we had one record we did with our old bass player, Rick, mm-hmm. that we kind of scrapped, and then we went and recorded a series of songs and decided that we needed some more. So in essence, there were like three.
We even did that twice, actually.
Yeah, we did it twice. So I think Dream All Day was from the last batch of stuff that we did, like, I don't know, October of last year.
An excellent song that it is.
Dankeschön.
And here it is, the Posies with Dream All Day.
Trying to understand.
All day.
from Pork Soda. That is Primus, a great new video.
How does Les Claypool do that with his leg is what I want to know. Show us, Dave.
Being a bass player, speaking of Les Claypool, what do you think of Les?
He's got impeccable style, but I don't go for that kind of thing.
Oh, really? Yeah. Personally? He was talking about how it was like the major thrill of his life to open up for Geddy Lee and Rush. Because
yeah,
he's the most... Now, what do you think of Geddy Lee as a bass player?
He rocks, too, but art rock is not my bag either.
Well, speaking of bags, you guys have, besides the Posies being your full-time thing, you guys are involved in a lot of other things. You guys seem to get around a lot. All four of you have different things going on besides the Posies.
Well, I produce some bands for the Sub Pop label and other labels like CZ. I did a record for a band called Gnome recently and a Pond record. I don't know if you guys have ever played any Pond. Agatha.
We played Pond.
I saw Pond.
Right,
and on the show.
Worked with Truly and mixed a Love Battery record. It's just a good way to keep busy and keep in the studio and make
and a
money.
Career maybe somewhere.
And it's a really good way to score.
After you guys part because of musical differences.
That's right.
Okay.
Oh, well, in addition to recently marrying a fastback, I'm
congratulations,
one-third.
By the way.
Oh, thank you.
Wait, when did you get married?
Gosh, it's
2 hours ago?
Over a month ago. It's so long ago.
A veritable newlywed.
Kim. Love ya. And no,
mean it.
Yeah. Missing ya. No, that's really mean. My little side project is known as Skookumvert. It's the first grunge rave hybrid that we know of, anyway.
You gotta be kidding me.
That's for real.
I can't even imagine what that's gonna sound like. Is it just all melting of all those styles?
Are you familiar with Steve Fisk?
No.
He produced early Screaming Trees, and he does lots of, like, he's like a technical wizard kind of guy. He does lots of keyboard stuff, and he's really amazing. He did that Steve and Jesse Bernstein record, all the background stuff, and he's a wacky guy.
We were talking about Reading earlier. You guys were
Noel Reading?
No, the Reading Festival in England, and you guys are playing with. You're actually going to play in Big Star as they play.
We did one show with them already. We did a thing in Columbia, Missouri. It was the official first reunion show or whatever, and it was a blast. So
you guys are like the Toto of the '90s. Not Toto. You know what I mean? You know how they played with everybody, and they were known as like really great musicians, just musicians.
Totally. Jeff Picaro.
I meant that in the nicest way, you know.
What does
I mean?
That mean for you, Mike? No. Stay away from those pesticides. Buddy.
Yeah, don't do any
gardening.
Exactly.
Okay, you guys are going to get back and play a song for us. So you stick around because...
Didn't we already do that?
No.
Oh, we haven't,
done,
done
that yet.
I think we're going to get back to our roots.
That's right.
What we're going
to
do.
Stay here, 120 minutes.
Into the future.
MTV had moved its operations and established a beachhead. It was my mission to find out what the hell they were doing.
I love the smell of cocoa butter in the morning. It smells like coconuts.
Every day they were bringing in fresh-faced kids who acted like they won some contest.
This house is just filled with energy, man. It's visionary. They're flying in one winner a day, man.
And one of them's gonna get Dr. Dre's car, you know? And it hops, man. It hops.
Their leader was quite possibly insane.
The slobster was alive when it hit the boiling, frothing water. Oh, the horror. The horror.
They say if you watch MTV, you'll understand. I still don't.
Dig this. Plug in. And win.
Brought to you by Pepe Jeans London.
We Playmates have the secret to happiness. The secret that brings you the world's most beautiful women. And their outrageous video, free.
Free?
Just make one call.
And learn the secret that brings you up close and personal with the world's most famous people.
And brings you the Playmate of the Year, back to campus girls, and the stars you love to look at.
Is this like a lamp you rub or something?
No, it's Playboy!
And the secret to happiness is yours in 12 great issues.
If you call our toll-free number right now.
And guess what? Call us today and we'll also send you our exciting Private Pleasures video absolutely free with your paid subscription.
And not available anywhere else. Collect this exclusive video of your favorite playmates.
Discover the secret to happiness. Call this number right now.
For your free video and us. Because we want to make you happy.
You ever negotiated with the Japanese before?
It's a partnership that's not supposed to work.
This is hardly a negotiation. It's a homicide.
It's a case.
Don't do anything.
They're not supposed to solve.
We're still the police in our own country.
It's a game. They're not supposed to win.
They won't get away with this.
Sean Connery, Wesley Snipes, from the number one bestseller, Rising Sun, July 30th, rated R.
Psst, come here.
Kind of reminds you of the disco era, doesn't it?
It's pretty neat. Very clever gizmo, I might say. I think it's an upper class of sneakers on the courts, I think. I load up, lace up, and I'm good to go. And all they see are these little lights flashing away. You get to see the light before you go up and slam on them. Bam! I think grandma would like a pair. You gotta own the light if you wanna own the night.
Subway will climb up to become the second largest restaurant chain in North America behind McDonald's. Our dedication to making fair sandwiches paid off. We thought we'd celebrate by climbing North America's second tallest mountain. So here we are, every Subway owner. Don't worry, we've got safety ropes. To thank you, we're having a 2-cent sale. Everyone who buys a medium or large soft drink automatically wins delicious Subway food for just 2 cents. Hey, look, a penny. I'm halfway there.
Come in and win. It's the 2-cent sale at Subway.
A trip to Six Flags or Disneyland, a dog's view. We all know Disneyland's a great place to visit, but if you don't have time for the trip this year, consider the alternative, Six Flags. Bigger. Faster. Closer. No matter where you live, there's one nearby. Plus, you get home in time to feed your dog. Six Flags theme parks. Bigger, faster, closer.
The best undressed bodies of 1993. What are they wearing? The barest essentials. What else are they wearing? Designer Imposters body sprays. They're designer quality fragrances, but not designer prices. They're only around $3 each. So let them fragrance you, refresh you, keep you cool and inviting all over. Designer Imposters body sprays, only from Parfums de Coeur. The best undressed bodies in the world wear them.
120 minutes. Back on 120 minutes with Ken and John of the Posies, who are about to weave their musical magic for us. And this is kind of your Allison of the record that contains the title of this of the album, but is not actually the title track, which you don't have. Frosting on the Beater, the song Solar Sister that you're about to play. Tell us about it.
Well, it's just one of it's kind of an anthem of admiration for a person that maybe doesn't appreciate themselves. So, but it's woven into all sorts of mysterious kind of things. Mystical, perhaps. No, not really, but...
Okay. There's a lot of succulent, dripping imagery, too.
Yeah.
Here they are, the Posies.
I call you Sister Carrie, but I never say it. Muted to a whisper. Solar system, a magnet will deliver an arrow from a quiver. I call you Sister Carrie, but you'll never hear it. 50 minutes later. as time pulls down her fader and nibbles off the fakers and roll under the breakers. I close my eyes and listen to you read the story, knowing I'll soon be left behind. So won't you read, Sister Carrie Jean, Sister Carrie, our insufficient one. And I call you Sister Carrie, I won't breathe the wood, the frosting on the beater, the flag drifts down the meter, thought you could delete her. Lucky you could meet her. I'll close my eyes and listen to you read the story, but I'm already far behind. So won't you read, Sister Carrie Jean, Sister Carrie, our insufficient one. Teach me a new story out of the pages of your mind. A magnet will deliver. Suspend my solar sister. And you can read, Sister Carrie, read, Sister Carrie, read, Sister Carrie, read, read.
Lewis Largent with you for the second 60 of MTV's 120 Minutes. If you just tuned in, you missed the sweet pop song stylings of the Posies, and we want to thank them for stopping by tonight. But the action is not going to stop. We got lots more to come, and we want to remind you to tune in next Sunday night at midnight, 11 Central, when those ultra-cool cats from Chicago, Urge Overkill, are going to be here. Still to come this morning, we got a road check with Frank Black and alternative music videos from Tool, the His Name is Alive, and the Reverend Horton Heat, Drumarama, PJ Harvey, and the Juliana Hatfield 3. We're going to kick off this second 60 with a world premiere video from Midnight Oil, second clip from their eighth album, Earth and Sun and Moon, and if I'm not mistaken, I might be wrong, first time they've ever had a song with the title of love in it. Here's Outbreak of Love from Midnight Oil.
The band has always been acute about the things that it's sung about, but I think with Earth, Sun and Moon, we've just gone for emotion. I mean, people don't need to be reminded of the poo that's falling out of the sky, you know. We've just got to figure out what we're going to do with it when it lands and how we're going to get out.
An outstanding video from Tool with Sober here on 120 Minutes, and outstanding because, believe it or not, it was directed by Fred Sturr, the same guy who did the Three Little Pigs video that became so huge for Green Jelly and took MTV by storm a couple months ago. Tool have now officially taken over for Babes in Toyland on the main stage of Lollapalooza 93, which hits Charlestown Races in Charlestown, West Virginia on Tuesday, Starlake Amphitheater in Pittsburgh on Wednesday, Walnut Creek Amphitheater in Raleigh, North Carolina on Friday, and Metrolina Fairgrounds in Charlotte, North Carolina on Saturday. So MTV's 120 Minutes, I'm Lewis Largent, and Frank Black has just wrapped up a U.S. tour of his own. I saw it when it came to New York. He was excellent. And he's got a new video called Hang On To Your Ego. And what do we got? We got this report. Hang on to your ego. Hang on, but I don't wanna go. I'm gonna lose it.
For the second video off his debut solo album, ex-Pixie Frank Black covered a Brian Wilson song called Hang On To Your Ego. The song is an alternate version of another song Wilson wrote for his former band The Beach Boys, called I Know There Is an Answer, a track off their legendary 1966 album Pet Sounds. To direct the video, Frank once again tapped They Might Be Giants guitarist John Flansburgh.
It's like one of these legendary Brian Wilson alternative takes. You know, there's a big cult group around Brian Wilson.
Well, there's a lyricist that worked with Brian Wilson. Brian Wilson commonly works, or commonly did work with lyricists, and Tony Asher was one of them.
He co-wrote all the songs on Pet Sounds, which is the album, the Beach Boys album that has, it's really one of the finest rock records of all time, and he co-wrote all the songs on that record except Hang On To Your Ego.
John Flansburgh was the director, and I just said, he said, let's get Brian Wilson, and we couldn't get Brian Wilson, so let's get Chris Elliott. And Chris Elliott couldn't do it because he had some sort of back problem. He couldn't come down. And so that was, get my little brother and get the guy Tony Asher,
Park was just, was hanging around. And, he's got a great screen presence. So we took advantage of it.
Well, he's a talented young man. And that performs superbly.
Also making an appearance in the video is Frank's fellow ex-Pixie, Joey Santiago, who's also joined Mr. Black on the road.
He was around, he was around for all the recordings pretty much, and even some of the mixing. So he was, we enjoyed his company constantly, and even when he wasn't playing on a particular track. So it seemed kind of an obvious choice to have him out on the road with us.
Also joining Frank on the road is the man who co-produced his album, ex-Perubu and Captain Beefheart keyboardist Eric Drew Feldman.
I like working with singers with big voices, actually, or big singers. And I've done some of that. And the man turns a good tune.
And for his next video, old Frank may have a couple surprises up his sleeve.
Now, I really, really want to get Milli Vanilli, the Milli Vanilli that everyone knows and loves, to do a video for me. I mean, up here, as me or whatever, or as the performer. Because I always kind of got a kick out of him. And I felt kind of bad for him when all that publicity happened, because after all, I mean, they just sort of got caught doing an old trick, basically.
So many people who think they can. Let's all close our eyes and get in touch with our animal spirits.
Well, he's just trying to be friendly.
MTV, to walk in truth and breathe fire, that's cool.
From Touchstone Pictures, Richard Dreyfuss and Emilio Estevez are back on another stakeout with a new partner.
I think that Bill should shave his mustache.
I have had this mustache for 13 years.
How long have you had yours?
If she could just get off their case.
You spineless selfish maggot! That's it!
They may solve this one.
Ooh. Cover me. I'm taking a bath.
Come on, get happy!
Another stakeout, rated PG-13. Starts Friday, July 23rd at a theater near you.
You want healthy, shiny hair? It comes from the inside out.
My hair wasn't always so healthy.
Now I use Pantene Pro-V shampoo and treatment conditioner every day. Pantene Pro-V has special provitamins. They penetrate to improve hair all the way to the tips. So what you get is healthy, shiny Pantene hair.
Pantene Pro-V, for hair so healthy, it shines.
Don't go another day without it.
It began for me when I saw Tony Dorsett in the Super Bowl. It began for me when I got the ring. For me, it's still the beginning.
The Reebok preseason shoe at Foot Locker, where it all begins.
I didn't seem to see too much savings.
But I do remember them telling me that I had made a great choice, but it just didn't work for me.
Well, I guess I had to learn the hard way.
Have you heard? Now AT&T could save you more than MCI or Sprint. If you spend $40 a month, you could save 25% off our basic rates on calls to your favorite area code and 15% off calls everywhere else anytime. Great prices, another part of the iPlan. Switch now. It's free. Just call 1-800-544-9990.
Service is a big, big feature with me.
Service is the key.
I switched back to AT&T, had the service that they're obviously known for.
So back to AT&T.
I just really wasn't that happy with it, so I switched back for free.
AT&T's the only choice.
I can't go wrong with AT&T.
Prices that could beat MCI or Sprint, plus the best customer service. I is for individual. It's why so many people are switching to AT&T.
Hi, I'm Clem.
I'm John.
And I'm Chris, and we're all from Dramarama, and you're watching 120 Minutes on MTV.
Into the future.
And we have Dramarama's Work for Food video along the way with an amazing, very kind of avant-garde, artsy kind of clip from His Name is Alive, and a brand new one from the Reverend Horton Heat. Right now, Slow Motion Replay, a brand new video from The, who are currently enjoying the success of their best-selling album, in, at least in the States, of their career, Dusk, and also getting ready to hit the road with Depeche Mode coming up in the fall. And according to frontman Matt Johnson, it would be nice to have even more.
Radio has never really got behind it fully. I mean, it seems to be better this time round, but it's a question of people hearing it. If people get to hear the stuff, they generally seem to quite like it, but I'd rather be at a larger level to have more economic power to do more adventurous projects.
Yes.
song was just, you know, in L.A. you see people with the sign, work for food all the time. And a lot of times people kind of ignore them, make believe they're not there. Put it in the first person. At the same time, I was having, you know, premonitions of the future, of my success as a rock musician, and imagined what it might be like to be that guy who was in this rock band and was out there. And basically, that's what the song's about.
Hey, listen here, Easdale, you're one stiff album away from those streets there, buddy. Drummerama there with Work for Food, the first video from Hi-Fi Sci-Fi. It's 120 minutes, stick around, we still got great videos. My favorite video probably at the moment, Man Size from PJ Harvey. We're going to be playing along with the Julianne Hatfield 3. And right after the break, a band currently, or just actually finished up on the road with Frank Black, the Reverend Horton Heat. So stay with us, won't you?
Down the street, and this guy starts with me. Hey, baby, yo, hey, miss, don't miss this, he says, and he grabs his crotch. Okay, buddy, come on. I got a huge bucket of non-dairy creamer and some time to kill, so let's make gallons of foul-smelling artificial milk, drink it till our bladders get painfully full, sit on the toilet together, let the water run in the shower, and torture ourselves by not letting ourselves urinate as water rushes into the bathtub, okay? What's the matter, baby? You got something against men? No, I say, I don't have anything against men, just stupid men.
Spend the summer with the family down the street.
I don't know who you are or where you're from.
We come from France?
Coneheads.
Are they from another planet?
If they're not, we should nuke France right away.
Rated PG. Starts Friday, July 23rd.
Goes every which way. I mean, how come your hair always goes the right way?
Suave hairspray. No, these.
Suave? Oh, great. So I'm running around buying the most expensive brands of hairspray.
Well, you just have to get with it.
Suave's all you use? Really?
That's it. Oh, those are the best ones yet. Except for this hair.
Stop it.
Suave hair care. When Suave works this well, why spend more?
Don't you drive around with Dr. Bernice. That ain't a real Cadillac. It's a Delta 88, spray painted black, with fake leather seats from Juarez.
And now today's traffic report from Super Mario Kart.
It's a real race out there today, folks. People are driving like animals. A turnpike split in two, and a turtle shell is making travel impossible for one motorist. Over on the freeway, it's bumper-to-bumper, door-to-door, wheel-to-wheel, you name it. And check your rear view. Some blockheads are causing major delays. There's already been one accident there. And watch out over on I-94. A banana peel is making things a little slippery. And that's traffic.
With two-player split-screen action, you've never been in a race like this. Super Mario Kart, only for the Super Nintendo Entertainment System. No wonder, the best play here.
She discovered that Max Factor's new eyeshadow gave her high-definition eyes. But then what?
The cute guy had been making eye contact from behind the pages of a Dickens classic. When she passed by him, she smiled and said, "Great book. It's even better right side up."
Impact.
Max Factor's new high-definition eyeshadow. Rich, refined, eyes they'll read up on. Max Factor International.
Paramount Pictures presents a comedy that's heads above the rest. Coneheads, rated PG. Starts Friday, July 23rd.
I'm John Doe.
And I'm Exine Cervenka.
We are from the band X.
And you're watching 120 Minutes.
On MTV.
Into the future.
Welcome back to MTV's 120 Minutes. Stay tuned for two of the coolest women in the alternative music world these days, PJ Harvey and Juliana Hatfield. And first, we're going to play you a brand new video from the Dallas band, the Reverend Horton Heat. And these guys are currently, I keep saying that the tour just ended. They've been out on the road with Frank Black, who's been talking about him on stage. And I want to thank you to the Reverend Horton Heat for showing up. And we were visiting with Frank recently. We asked him how he hooked up with the good Reverend.
Yeah, I mean, we just, you know, called the usual people and inquired about his availability, and we're honored that he was so gracious to accept the tour.
Thank you. Consider the alternatives. MTV's Alternative Nation presents the Spin Doctors Tour.
Shucks, it's so sad. What time is it?
With special guests Soul Asylum and Screaming Trees coming to a city near you. Watch Alternative Nation for details. This MTV tour is presented by Apple Computer. The power to be your best.
Hi, I'm Kim Fields. You know, I am constantly asked, how do you break into showbiz? Well, my friends at Future Publications have put together a packet loaded with valuable information on writing a resume, getting an agent, locating acting jobs, and a wealth of other helpful information.
This could turn your dreams into a reality. And as a bonus, the packet has a current national list of talent agencies.
You don't have to live in Hollywood. Your acting career can begin anywhere in the country.
New faces are being sought by the TV, movie, and commercial industries every day.
This packet can turn your dreams into a lucrative showbiz career.
To order, call 1-800-290-1010, $29.95 plus $4.95 shipping and handling. Major credit cards and CODs are accepted, or send check or money order to Future Publications, 8306 Wilshire Boulevard, Suite 501, Beverly Hills, California, 90211. Allow 1 to 2 weeks for delivery. That's 1-800-290-1010. Operators are standing by.
20th Century Fox presents...
Robin Hood.
Check, please. Oh! More bubbles. Oh! Now it's happening.
A chastity belt?
Man, white men can't jump.
Robin Hood, Men in Tights. A Mel Brooks film. Rated PG-13.
Starts Wednesday, July 28th at theaters everywhere.
Imagine if you could always do things your way. Like, if you were a cartoon. Then you could give yourself your own footlocker with tons of Filo Rumball shoes. And then you could really jam. Of course, you're not a cartoon. Lucky for you, Foot Locker has tons of Filo Rumball shoes. Hey, it's a start. Foot Locker, where it all begins.
Combinations are there.
Combinations?
Fruit flavor combinations.
Are in every bag of Skittles.
Skittles. Well, there's Grapeberry.
Grapeberry. What?
It's a name thing. Like Lim Lamore.
Lemma Lemma Lemma.
No,
what?
No, like lemon, lime, and orange.
See, every Skittles combination is a new taste with a new name.
New taste, new name. New taste, new name.
Oh, I get
and
it.
Strawberry.
Lemon.
Orange.
Orange, remember name?
Perhaps not. So how many combinations are there in every bag of Skittles bite-sized candies?
Find out for yourself.
Taste the rainbow. Can I try it again?
I'm Mark E. Smith from The Fall, and you are watching 120 Minutes on MTV.
Into the future.
Mark E. Smith kind of going to that Keith Richards school of how to look like a rock star. Thanks very much for staying up late with 120 Minutes. I'm Louis Largent, and unfortunately, it's time for the final video on 120 Minutes. And it's a gooder, Juliana Hatfield, and her band now, the Juliana Hatfield 3. And she's solidified a steady lineup, and that being the reason for the band name as opposed to just saying Juliana Hatfield. The new album is called Become What You Are, and here's Juliana way back last year during her solo days to talk about her lyrics.
I can expose the pathetic side of me in songs. Like, they're not really me, they're a way that I can let out the pathetic parts of my personality, but I'm not really like that in real life.
My sister, my sister.
That is the Juliana Hatfield 3 with my sister here on 120 Minutes. The final video on tonight's show. We welcome your comments and suggestions. Send them to 1515 Broadway, 24th floor, New York, New York, 136. And thanks for the posies for stopping by. We got Urge Overkill coming on to 120 next Sunday night at midnight, 11 Central. And don't forget that Kennedy is your host for Alternative Nation, weeknights at midnight. Thank you very much for watching. For 120 Minutes, I'm Louis Largent. See you later. And now we resume normal broadcasting. Hi, it's me, Louis, again. And we're going to play AC/DC, Matthew Sweet, and Stone Temple Pilots this hour. But first, let's kick things off with R.E.M. going back a few years for It's the End of the World as We Know It.
That's great. It starts with an earthquake, birds and snakes, an airplane. Lenny Bruce is not afraid. To yourself, turn world, serve its own needs. Dummy, serve your own needs. Beat it up a notch, speed, grunt, no strength. The ladder starts to clatter with fear, fight down. High wire and a fire, representing seven games in a government for hire and a combat site. Left to us are coming in a hurry with the furies breathing down your neck. Team, my team, reporters, babble, Trump, Kevin Croft. Look at that, no plane, fine, then. Uh-oh, overflow, population, common food, but it'll do. Save yourself, serve yourself, world, serve its own needs. Listen to your heartbeat, dummy, with the rapture and the reverend. Slash and burn, return, listen to yourself, churn. Lock it in, uniform and book, burning blood, letting every motive escalate. Automotive, centerate, light a candle, light a motor, step down, watch your heel crush, crush. Uh-oh, this means no fear, cavalier, renegade, steer clear. A tournament of lies. Offer me solutions, offer me alternatives, and I decline. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. I feel fine. I feel fine. It's the end of the world as we know it. Drifted by mountains, sit in a line. Leonard Bernstein, Leonid, Brasnap, Lenny Bruce and Lester Banks. Birthday party, cheesecake, jelly bean, boom. Symbiotic, patriotic, slam, button, that. Right?
Right.
It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. I feel fine.
Onyx Aerosmith and a gentleman by the name of Matthew Sweet. You remember him from Girlfriend fame. He's got a new one. Check it out next.
V had moved its operations and established a beachhead. It was my mission to find out what the hell they were doing.
I love the smell of cocoa butter in the morning. It smells like coconuts.
Every day they were bringing in fresh-faced kids who acted like they won some contest.
This house is just filled with energy, man. It's visionary. They're flying in one winner a day, man. And one of them, man, one of them's gonna get Dr. Dre's car, you know? And it hops, man. It hops.
Their leader was quite possibly insane.
The slobster was alive when it hit the boiling, frothing water. Oh, the horror. The horror.
They say if you watch MTV, you'll understand. I still don't.
Dig this. Plug in. And win.
Brought to you by Starburst Fruit Chews. Listen.
I will be so glad to get out of here.
To your generation.
Don't start no fight now.
Listen.
I'm a black woman, okay? I deserve respect.
To your world.
Figure out what you're gonna do with your life.
Listen.
How can you be in love if you don't know nothing about it?
To your heart.
Nobody can make it out here alone.
Janet Jackson, Tupac Shakur, Poetic Justice. From the director of Boys in the Hood. Rated R. At Theaters Friday.
Yeah, you're right, Judd. There's no beach traffic.
Easy. I went out. There's a Coke machine.
Man, I'm so hot.
You certainly are.
Hot as in sweaty.
Okay, so crank on the AC.
Air conditioning is for the weak, like yourself.
I'm sticking to the seat, like yourself.
That please dog is moving faster than we are.
All you guys ever do is complain.
Your shoes are pretty.
Could someone please fan me?
No.
Coca-Cola, anyone?
Yay!
Thank you, Alan, for serving a purpose in my life for the first time.
Well, you're very welcome.
She knew Max Factor's high-definition lipstick gave her lips bold, brave color. But then what?
From across the restaurant, the stranger watched her eat, laugh, and smile. When her companion finally left the table, she carefully mouthed the words, "He's my brother."
Max Factor's new high-definition lipstick. Bold, brave, true. Lips they'll listen to. Max Factor International.
This year, Subway will climb up to become the second largest restaurant chain in North America behind McDonald's. Our dedication to making fair sandwiches paid off. We thought we'd celebrate by climbing North America's second tallest mountain. So here we are, every Subway owner. Don't worry, we've got safety ropes. To thank you, we're having a 2-cent sale. Everyone who buys a medium or large soft drink automatically wins delicious Subway food for just 2 cents. Hey, look, a penny. I'm halfway there.
Come in and win. It's the 2-cent sale at Subway.
Did you hear about Color Quick from Q-Tex? It's really great. By the time you get to your pinky, your thumb is dry. Cool. It's new Color Quick from Q-Tex.
The best undressed bodies of 1993. What are they wearing? The barest essentials. What else are they wearing? Designer Imposters body sprays. They're designer quality fragrances, but not designer prices. They're only around $3 each. So let them fragrance you, refresh you, keep you cool and inviting all over. Designer Imposters body sprays, only from Parfums de Coeur. The best undressed bodies in the world wear them.
Carrie Jacobson's a milk drinker. Once I saw her, I had to meet her. She says milk helps with shiny hair and beautiful skin. She's right, she's gorgeous. She gets a lot of attention. For me, she gets total attention. Milk does a body good.
What is Whirly Ball? Whirly Ball is fun, fun for everyone. That's why Whirly Ball is a perfect place for your next date, party, or corporate event. Each Whirly Ball court has party rooms available for before and after the game. And don't forget to visit our snack bar. Easy to get to from anywhere in the Chicagoland area. Come find out why Whirly Ball is being called the indoor sport of the 90s. Call 708-932-4800 or toll free 1-800-8-WHIRLY to make your reservations today.
Now available from Stage Fright, a terrific video for your favorite preschooler. Big rigs, close up, and very personal. Experience what goes on in the day-to-day operation of huge 18-wheelers. Enjoy 30 minutes of live-action trucks on the move. Big rigs, close up, and very personal. Only $14.95. Order from Stage Fright, 708-208-9845.
I'm Larry Mullen from U2. I'm a drummer and I ride a bike. To do both, there are two things you gotta do. Stay vertical and don't get shredded.
I work my ass off. And all I've got to show for it, Velcro and MTV.
I work my blank off, and all I've got to show for it is blank and MTV.
Got it.
begun. Now everybody is on the run. What did her daddy do? It's Janie's last IOU. She had to take him down easy and put a bullet in his brain. She said, 'cause nobody believes me, the man was such a sleazy.
Make noisy boys! So we know you're so sick of Stone Temple Pilots, but we got something for you, an acoustic version of Plush to breathe some new life into it. So stick around for that. It's really great.
MTV Party to Go. Fierce. Non-stop. Dance mixes. Of all your favorite music. It will move you. Volumes 3 and 4 in stores now.
There's a good reason they made their new antiperspirant more powerful, harder working than ever before. They had to keep up with me. New Secret Roll-On. It's more effective. Now Secret's new formula keeps you drier than ever. Secret's still pH balanced. It just works harder. Like you. Strong enough for a man, but new Secret keeps a woman even drier.
The 3-2 pitch, fastball, belted, and Bo
has it! I heard Bo is so strong it could check swing a home.
I believe that.
I heard Bo is so fast he could turn off the bedroom lights and be in the sack before the room gets dark.
I believe that.
I heard Bo is so good that he can throw out a runner on the fly from a warning track.
So?
Underhand.
Oh, we'll be back after this.
I heard Bo spent 2,180 hours rehabbing his hip just so he could play baseball.
2,180
hours
rehabbing his hip
just so he can play baseball?
I don't believe that.
But I did hear Bo once climbed up Fenway's Green Monster, bought a hot dog, but still had enough time to catch the ball.
He getting mustard on that dog?
No mustard.
I believe that.
First things first.
Before the hair, before the makeup, before there's beautiful skin. CoverGirl introduces new Clearly Different Deep Cleansing Face Wash. Clearly different. It cleans deep, yet cares for your skin to thoroughly foam away dirt, oil, even makeup, leaving your skin clean, fresh, clearly beautiful. Discover the skin-caring difference of new Clearly Different Deep Cleansing Face Wash.
First things first.
From the new CoverGirl Clean Skin Care Collection, where naturally beautiful skin begins.
You want a taste you can't resist? There's no bad chip you can pop like this. Yeah, once you start, there's no stopping. So many ways to get Pringles popping.
The Pringles can't stop. The Pringles can't stop.
You got the sack, you got the bunch. For a whole lot of taste of the Pringles crunch. You got the duck-billed lizard too. Only Pringles rings taste like this to you.
The Pringles can't stop. Pop the Pringles can't
stop. So pop the can for fresh hot chips. Nothing like Pringles crush your lips. Yeah, once you pop, you can't stop.
Wouldn't you give anything for hair that's shiny and healthy? Blow drying gave me split ends. But Pantene Pro-V Shampoo and Treatment Conditioner helped change all that. Pro-V contains pro-vitamins which go deep into your hair, giving it extra treatment all the way to the tips. And look, it's so healthy, it shines.
Pantene Pro-V Shampoo and Treatment Conditioner for hair so healthy it shines.
It won't happen overnight, but it will happen.
Do not adjust your television. The sound you hear. Is the future. MTV Buzz Clips. Plug in.
song called Plush.
And I feel the time's a waste to go. So where are you going to tomorrow? And I see that these are lies to come. Would you even care? Smell her. Well, she smell alone. And I feel so much depends on the weather. So is it raining in your bedroom? And I see these are the eyes of disarray. Would you even care? I found, and I feel when the dogs begin to smell her. Well, she smell alone. When the dogs you find her, got time to wait for tomorrow to find it. To find it, to find it. When the dogs you find her, got time to wait for tomorrow. To find it, to find it, to find it. Ooh.
Def Leppard go on the road and strip down. Next in MTV News.
Beth desperately seeks real life in the land of backstabbing trolls and transplants, looking for challenges in work and play. Meet her on MTV's Real World 2, Thursdays at 10.
In the Line of Fire is the best movie of the summer. Siskel and Ebert give it two big thumbs up. And Joel Siegel raves, movies don't get more exciting than this. Clint Eastwood, In the Line of Fire, rated R, at theaters now.
And now today's traffic report from Super Mario Kart.
It's a real race out there today, folks. People are driving like animals. A turnpike split in two, and a turtle shell is making travel impossible for one motorist. Over on the freeway, it's bumper-to-bumper, door-to-door, wheel-to-wheel, you name it. And check your rear view. Some blockheads are causing major delays. There's already been one accident there. And watch out over on I-94. A banana peel is making things a little slippery. And that's traffic.
With two-player split-screen action, you've never been in a race like this. Super Mario Kart, only for the Super Nintendo Entertainment System. No wonder, the best play here.
A revolution is underway. 1-800-COLLECT. Now America's least expensive way to call someone collect. All across America, people are dialing it instead of zero to make the long-distance charges easier for their friends and family to accept.
Come talk to me.
They've been given the choice. They're making the change.
Come talk to me.
1-800-COLLECT.
Sure, sure, sure. Unsure. Sure.
When dryness really counts, be sure to be dry. Sure Solid has the most effective wetness fighting ingredient you can buy. For dryness, no one can beat. So you're either sure or
unsure.
Be sure to be dry.
To clean in proper order. Glasses, silverware, dishes, then pans.
Or greasy.
Mommy never says you, Daddy.
Because Dawn cleans the greasiest grease. Dawn breaks it up and takes it away.
Oh, no, we forgot a glass and the water's all greasy.
What are we gonna do? Let's do what Mommy would do. See? The glass isn't greasy. Neither are my hands.
It goes there.
And I thought your mother was tough.
Dawn takes grease out of your way.
Now available from Stage Fright, a terrific video for your favorite preschooler. Big rigs, close up, and very personal. Experience what goes on in the day-to-day operation of huge 18-wheelers. Enjoy 30 minutes of live-action trucks on the move. Big rigs, close up, and very personal. Only $14.95. Order from Stage Fright, 708-208-9845.
The government recently established procedures to evaluate cable TV rates.
Because cable TV is such an important part of American life, it deserves the attention.
But the process won't be fast or easy, requiring considerable paperwork for both regulators and cable companies.
Changes in your bill likely won't occur before fall. We'll keep you posted.
Meanwhile, at Jones Intercable, we'll keep delivering the outstanding cable value you deserve.
I'm Allison Stewart, and this is MTV News. And another summer concert report. Def Leppard kicked off the month of July by hitting the roads of North America for a stripped-down summer tour with a back-to-basics approach that offers a stark contrast to last year's big in-the-round concert production. We caught up with them on one of their first dates in Sacramento, California, and here is how it went.
Everybody's getting along mighty fine, I've got to admit. You know, we're having a ball, we're out on the road. What can really, you know, what can you not be enjoying about it? Summertime touring is great. Like I said, shorts, shirts, no shoes. I can kind of walk around half naked, which is much better than wearing coats and hats and gloves, which is what we did for the majority of the Adrenalized tour, which was August till April. That was all in the round as well. This time around, we're doing the outdoors at one end, which is a whole new aspect.
It's a lot more basic, you know, there's no lasers or anything, it's just a band.
The other change this time around for Def Leppard is touring with an opening act, Ugly Kid Joe.
It's a bit of a riot. It reminds me of us in Pyromania days.
Look, look. Metal bimbos, look back there, look back there, look back there, look over there.
No, they're good guys, you know, and it's nice to go out with a band because the entire In the Round tour of America was an evening with Def Leppard. It's very insular, just us and the crew and us and the crew. This time we've got a support act, and it's nice to see them go down real well, and then you have to go out there and work a bit harder.
Def Leppard's new single, Two Steps Behind, is from the hit soundtrack to the box office bomb Last Action Hero. Whatever you do, I'll be two steps behind you. It's also a preview of sorts of their next project.
We got a new album coming out.
The album's called Retroactive, and I mean, the title speaks for itself. What it is, it's an album that kind of, it mixes a lot of old material and new material that's never been on a Def Leppard LP before. There'll be a Def Leppard album that says 1992, and then there'll be another one that says 1993, not 1997, as everybody would be predicting.
Def Leppard and Ugly Kid Joe play Cincinnati on Tuesday. That is the news for now. We'll be back with more news later right here on MTV.
MTV News. You hear it first.
We're Not Blinds and U2 and Janet Jackson. Excuse me, I was about ready to burp there, and I'm glad you weren't around for it. And we're going to play the Spin Doctors right now with Little Miss Can't Be Wrong.